Alright people, as promised, we are back with another video. We are going to introduce you to dreamers, mentors and places. Today I have an interesting story. At the age of 42, on daily basis, he cycles around 20 kilometers and he does yoga. He is one of the fittest GM I have ever met. We are talking about none other than Tausif Ahmed Khan. He is the GM of Forum Mall Koramangala. So let's see what is his daily routine and let's see what secrets he has. Come on. Channel, we are so glad you took out time for us. Thank you so much.
My pleasure.
For our audience, could you just tell what you do?
So, my name is Tausif Ahmed Khan. I work for Forum Mall. I head one of the shopping center in Bangalore, and it's been 3.5 years. I'm staying in Bangalore and working here.
Where are you from?
So basically, I'm born and brought up in Orissa, but I was in Mumbai for 17 years, and then I've been shifted to Bangalore.
You were in the same field?
Yes, there also I was working for a shopping mall.
Shopping mall. How is the work experience with shopping mall? We just go to, you know, see happy faces and, you know, we don't know what goes behind. How is the work there?
It's very interesting and exciting, and with that little bit of pressure. It's all how you manage and how you, you know, how good your team is and how you are leading the team. Mm-hmm. It's a very exciting industry, a very small industry, but a lot of energy because every time you have to think for something new, what you want to bring new to the platter for the customers. So yes, every time you have to think and come up with some new ideas for customers.
Yep. Always your mind should be working.
Yes.
Innovative and so
you have to be ahead of the time.
Ahead of the time.
Yes.
Very well said. So why we are here is basically we are attracted towards your personality. Okay. The personality, not only what you speak, the knowledge what you possess, the personality as in the way you have maintained yourself. So if you don't mind, what is your age?
I am 42 plus.
42. Plus, he is 42 plus, and we saw your video of cycling just now. So, how many kilometers did you you went? I'm sorry, I'm asking you again.
So, I did 50 kilometers today.
Yeah.
But on an average, like as I mentioned, I do 2 to 3 times a week cycling. So, okay. On weekdays, I generally do between 20 to 30 kilometers.
Okay.
And on weekends, depend on 50, 75, up to 100 kilometers on weekends.
All right. Was this hobby developed recently or are you...
So before cycling, I used to do running. Okay. I have done a couple of half marathon, mm-hmm. and I used to do yoga. But yes, recently because of the COVID, you cannot go out, and I think cycling was one of the best thing, mm-hmm. to do. And it is very similar to running because, mm-hmm. Running and swimming, these are the exercise where your entire body, each part of your body is involved in that exercise, mm-hmm. and same way with the cycling as well. So I think a year now I have, yeah. developed this, mm-hmm. passion, and I'm cycling.
Okay, so cycling is from 1 year,
yes,
max, and before that you were running.
right? Yes.
So 42 years, that means like since when are you into this?
So I'll tell you, my father, he is around 76 now.
Okay.
And God bless, he is healthy.
Mm-hmm.
Whenever we meet him, he stays to the native place, and on and off he keeps coming. So whenever I meet him, first thing is ask, how are you, how's your health? And he tells the health is the first thing. If your health is good, rest everything will fall in place. So it's been 20 years I started my careers, and from the career only I started fitness. In fact, during my school days, I used to do a little bit of boxing in summer holidays.
Okay.
And when I started my career in Mumbai in 2000,
mm-hmm.
and that is the time I started gymming as well. So today it's 2020, it's more than 20 years now. And I'll tell you, my weight, I have maintained between 70 to 73 kg. It has never gone up to 73.
Okay.
In fact, it has gone to 67 when I was doing a half marathon.
Okay.
But it has never gone beyond 73 in this past 20 years.
You must be dieting also?
Absolutely no. I have a very sweet tooth. I love sweets. I cannot start my day without a sweet. So my first day is either a date, 3 peas and almonds, or something my wife makes, very lovely foods. And so gajar ka halwa, ande ka halwa, all these things I start my, I cannot start my day without some sweets. And I love vegetarian and non-vegetarian food. So I'm very foodie. I used to eat vada pavs almost alternate day while driving in Mumbai.
Okay.
Here also we go to Fraser Town, and
yeah.
there are places where we go and
yeah.
eat anything. I don't restrict. But only thing what I do is that I make sure that 1 hour in the morning is I should sweat. And that have been following from more than 20 years. So whether it's running, cycling, yoga, or anything, 1 hour sweat has helped me to keep myself healthy.
And you can eat anything?
I eat anything.
Wow.
Anything. Samosa, vada pav, like I said.
So, I mean, a lot of us, you know, we have this problem because, you know, maybe because we are starting late, realizing it late, and then we are controlling our food, then getting into exercise, you know, that's why we keep dieting as a very important thing.
See, it's the day you realize, that is the day, there never it is late.
Okay.
And what I have been following is that in my diet, so I make sure that I generally have 6 to 7 meals. I don't take 3 meals, right?
Okay.
So one of the good size of a ball, you eat fruits, whether it's a papaya is my favorite.
Okay.
So papaya, watermelon, muskmelon, one ball of food I eat definitely.
Okay.
And good quantity, similar, one ball of salad is must,
okay.
right? Rest, whatever you eat is absolutely not a problem. Like whether you are a fish lover, chicken lover, meat lover, vegetarian, whatever you eat doesn't matter. But if you just make sure that you have a little bit of salad, little bit of fruits,
mm-hmm.
you are done.
All right, great. And today you did some yoga also. Okay, could you just explain me about that session? Like, is it advisable for a person like me?
It's a very simple, and this can be done by anybody, anywhere. Even you don't have a yoga mat, it is not required. So one, like, and even if you Google the yoga for beginners, follow that, it's very simple. So in yoga, there are 2-3 exercises where, like, power yoga, Surya Namaskar, and there are few asanas which is little practice required, but most important thing is that breathing exercise.
Okay.
There are 3-4, I have shown you some breathing exercise. Like, it, in fact, it helps you in COVID as well.
Yeah.
Right,
yeah.
Because when you just, if you do Kapalbhati 10 minutes, you will start sweating. Just 10
just
minutes
by up. Sitting there.
Wherever you are sitting, even if you're sitting in your office chair,
okay.
you just have to sit down and do 10 minutes. You don't have to go out anywhere. We used to say that I'm telling you, you have to take out time 30 minutes. I'm saying, even if you're not getting, sit on your dining table chair, mm-hmm. sit on your office chair, on your bed when you get up. okay. Have your warm water and then you just have it on your bed only 10.
Empty stomach?
It's better. Empty stomach or very light something you had or a water something. Okay. And then you can have. There is no hard and fast when and how. Only thing is that you should not do it when your stomach is full. After the meal, okay. You should not do it.
Okay. Yeah. Sir, Tausif sir, will it be right if I say, you know, physical exercise has helped you grow professionally as well?
Yes, it is very, very important for you to be healthy because it gives a lot of impact to you during your working hours because like you get up early and sweat for 1 hour. So that gives you energy for the entire day. Mm-hmm. And definitely you have an energy entire day to deal with your people and definitely it is going to help you.
Professionally you grow?
Of course, yes.
As you were saying, you've grown from...
Yeah, I started my career as a waiter and today I'm heading one of the shopping mall. Of course, just because of, yes, hard work, with that there are a lot of contribution to your lifestyle and what you do and how you do.
Could you mention lifestyle? So, I would like to know how is your day, how it starts and ends?
So, I start my day around 5:30, 5:45, max 6 and because Fajr timing is around that time, so you have to get up before that. I finish my prayer and then after that, if I do yoga, so 6:30 to 7:30 is yoga. Or if I do cycling, then 6 o'clock or 6:30 I leave and 1 hour I do cycling on weekdays. So after that, I come freshen up, I have my breakfast, then you know, Mumbai, Bangalore, you need 1 hour of driving, then I reach to my office. Till 7 o'clock in my office, then again I start driving from my office and then back
lunch,
home.
Do you eat outside or is it?
Most of the time I carry my lunch because I know I'm my wife, she knows that I'm very foodie. So if I don't get anything in my dabba, so I'll go out and eat. So she gives me some fruits and she gives me some lunch and then I also keep some munching stuff.
Okay.
In my office as well, like peanuts, cashews, and some dry fruits, and some namkeens, like those things I keep in my office as well. Sometimes you feel hungry, then you can.
So during the office hours, also do you do Kapalbharati or sometimes when you get time? You usually don't get. I've seen you usually don't get time. I mean, you're very hectically busy. So do you take out time then or is it required or is it like morning you have done workout and the whole day it is your quota is done?
It's not like that. So generally we do a lot of sitting jobs. So every 2 hour, 2.5 hour, you just even if you're talking, just walk while you talk and so that will help you because continuously sitting is also a problem that is more dangerous than a cigarette. So you should keep walking as and when, whenever you get that time.
Like every half an hour or 1 hour?
No, even 2 to 3 hours also, if you get a call, you just go out and talk while you are walking. That also helps you. Right. After you finish your lunch, do a quick walk. That's also important. Again, in the evening, so whenever you get time, you just try to move your body. That's important. Don't keep sitting. If you're walking job, that's the best thing.
All right. Amazing. This is all gold for us. Okay. So I'm sure you as your father has included, you know, physical fitness in your parenting and your kids also. How many kids do you have?
So I have three kids, three daughters.
What are
their
names?
Zeenat, Zara and Zeba.
Zeenat, Zara and Zeba.
Yes.
You're like obsessed with Z.
Yes.
Zeenat, Zara. All right, I'm sure they are very lucky kids, you know, having a father who is like good looking and physically fit at the age of 21, you said?
Who said? No, 42.
All right, on that positive note, thank you so much for sparing some time with us. Any few words for the audience and your staff, future staff, previous staff, anyone who looks at you like an... Idol, I do, and so please, any words?
So it's a very, very important thing that, as I mentioned, my father used to say that you should be healthy. You have to invest a little bit of time and little bit of money on yourself. Even if sometimes your wife doesn't like, it's okay because end of the day, if you are healthy, you will be able to take care of them better.
Yeah.
And the most important thing is that you are going to spend money.
Yeah.
Whether you are going to spend those money today on your exercise, buying some almonds, dry fruits, or later you pay those money to the hospital.
Hospital bills.
The choice is yours.
Yep.
But this money you are not going to save.
Yep.
So better you invest on yourself.
Yep.
It will give you a longer life, better and healthy life.
Yep.
Where in indirectly it will make you healthy and your family will be healthy, because see especially for you know, people like women, men or women, whoever they are earning, they have their parents, kids and lot of responsibility and as well as liabilities. So if you are healthy, all these will be taken care well. If you are not wealthy, you try to save this money, then later you have to pay those in form of hospital bills. You have to decide what you want to do.
Absolutely. On that positive note, we are going to end. That was Mr. Torche from Forum. Take care until next time.
So, this is Zeba. Say hi.
Hi.
And that's Zara. And that's Zeenat.
Let's make this world a better place.